be taking you through WordPress's administrator dashboard. The dashboard gives you access to all the options and features available in WordPress. To access the dashboard, simply click on your theme's login link. If your theme does not have a login link, type /wp-admin after your website's URL in your browser's address bar. Enter your username and password to access the administrator dashboard. After successfully logging into WordPress, the dashboard will be the first page that you will see. The dashboard is made up of three different sections: the admin bar, the main navigation, and the work area. The admin bar appears on every page of your site, including the public view, but it is only visible to users who are logged into your website, so normal visitors will not see this. The admin bar displays the name of your website. When you hover over it, a link to visit your homepage appears. Clicking on either the name of your website or the link below will take you to the public view of your site. Notice that in the public view, the drop-down menu has changed, and it now includes more links that will take you back to different pages within your administrator dashboard. In the public view of your website, you also get a search bar located on the far right of the admin bar. To use it, click on the magnifying glass and type any keyword or phrase for the post or page that you're looking for, then hit enter on your keyboard. Clicking on your site's name again will bring you back into the dashboard. Notice that the search bar tab no longer appears when you're in the dashboard. Hovering over the username on the right side of the admin bar will reveal links to your profile settings and a link to log out of WordPress. You will also see the first and last name of the user who is currently logged in, along with a picture and the username. To change any of these, click on the Edit Profile link. Also, keep in mind that the image is being generated by the gravatar attached to the user's email. If you don't have a gravatar, you can go to gravatar.com and get an account. This will not only allow you to have a picture displayed on your dashboard, but you will have an image that follows you from site to site appearing beside your name when you do things like comment or post on a blog. The WordPress logo reveals links to the WordPress.org homepage, the WordPress documentation, the support forums, and a feedback page. The About WordPress link takes you to a page that explains the changes in the current version of WordPress that you're using. You might want to take a minute and browse through this page and see what's new with your installation. The Add New tab gives you access to adding a new post, media, link, page, or user. We will talk more about these individually in the following videos. The Comments tab will take you to the Comments page, where you can manage all the comments on your website. Remember, the admin bar is only visible to logged in users, but if you would like to disable this feature, you can do so in your user profile. Hovering over your name in the admin bar and selecting Edit My Profile will give you access to your profile settings. You can also get to the profile settings from any other page in your dashboard by selecting the Your Profile link in the Users drop-down menu. From this page, you can uncheck the box that reads Show Toolbar When Viewing Site to disable the admin bar. This is not a global option. If you have multiple users, you will need to disable it on all the user profiles. Click on Update Profile to save any changes you've made. The admin bar also warns you when you have updates to any plugins, themes, and even WordPress itself. The warning shows up as two arrows going in a circle with a number indicating the number of items you need to update. You can click on this tab to update your items, or you can click on the Update submenu tab under Dashboard in the main navigation. In this example, you'll see that I have to update two of my themes, the 2010 theme and the 2011 theme. The 2011 theme is the theme that we're using for this video series. On the far left side of the screen, you will see the main navigation menu, which contains links to all of your WordPress administrative functions. Hovering over any item will reveal submenu items. Clicking on the Collapse Menu link at the bottom of the main navigation will minimize the entire menu bar, only displaying the icons for each item. Click on the Collapse Menu icon once again to bring the menu titles back. The Work area is in the center of the page, and it displays modules that inform you or give you quick access to the administrative operations of your website. The Right Now module gives you the most current information about your website, such as the number of posts you currently have published, the total number of comments in your website, the theme being used, and the WordPress version your site is currently running. The Recent Comments module allows you to see and moderate the most recent comments. You can hover over an individual comment and approve, reply, edit, mark it as spam, or delete it directly from this module. The Quick Press module allows you to quickly create new posts directly from the dashboard by simply entering a title and adding content. In this module, you can also insert images, video, and other files you will like by clicking on the Upload Media icon. You can also add tags, which are similar to keywords. They describe the content on your website and make it easy for your users to find similar content. You can save your draft or publish the post to your website by clicking on the blue button labeled Publish. Don't worry if I'm going too fast. We will cover posts and adding media in later videos. The Recent Drafts module will display your most recent posts which you have started but you have not published. Any of the modules in the work area can be collapsed simply by hovering over the title of the module and clicking on the down pointing arrow, or by simply clicking in the title bar itself. Clicking in the title bar again will expand the module. Some modules contain extra options that further customize your WordPress workflow. To access these extra options, hover over the title of a module and click on Configure. If the Configure link does not appear, then there are no extra options for that particular module. The most recent RSS feed shows the most recent post by the WordPress official blog. This feed can be changed to any other RSS feed that you like by hovering over the title and clicking on Configure. For example, you can add the feed to my blog at http://feeds.feedburner.com/marketingunfolded, and then adding Marketing Unfolded to the feed title input box. You can set the number of posts you want to display, and you can select the different options about your feed. Once you have entered all the information, click on Submit to update your module. And now you can see that the RSS feed shows the most recent posts for marketingunfolded.com. You can further customize the look of your work area by enabling or disabling modules. You can do this by clicking on Screen Options on the admin bar and checking or unchecking the box next to the name of each module. Notice that when I click on the checkbox, the module appears and reappears. You can also change the number of columns in which to display the modules. I like the two-column view, but feel free to change it to anything else if it works better for you. To rearrange the modules in your work area, hover your cursor over the title of any module until your cursor changes into a four-way arrow. This lets you know that the module can be moved. Click and drag the module to a new location on the page. Release your module when you see a dotted outline in the space where you want to place the module. Feel free to change any screen options that you like and move modules around to better suit your workflow. This wraps up this video. In the next video, we'll be talking about creating and editing posts.